Hey, Niamh.
How are you?
How's it going?
You don't know who I am.
No, no I don't. No. No.
You know what? I knew you wouldn't. It's okay.
Yeah.
I knew you wouldn't.
All right.
So this is it. We just sit in silence, is it?
We could do that if you like. What do you do?
Okay, so I'm an engineer and scientist, and I'm also an artist and performer, combining the two to ignite people's curiosity. And more recently, I'm probably known because I'm planning my own personal mission to get to space. Yeah, you're having one of those nights.
No, I just...
Yeah, we're going to go there. We're going
to
go there.
Why would you want to go to space?
I take it you don't.
Well, I tell you, we're in space. This
yes,
is space. All,
yes, you're right. All the time we're in space.
I was, you know, the guy Elon Musk.
Yeah, he's...
Was saying, oh, and he didn't have this accent, but he was going, we should all live on Mars. And he talked about how, oh, when we get to Mars, it'll be, you know, we'll be out amongst the stars. Yeah. But isn't that where we are, like?
Yeah, we're already? Always in space. Yeah. We're always in space. You're right.
So tell me about the you're trying to get to space.
Yeah.
For how long and what do you do when you get there or?
Well, I tell you why. It's probably easier to start with the why. Okay. So there's kind of two reasons. One is that I started this quite late in life. So it's interesting for me as an artist to look at it in terms of what do you do with those dreams that you had as a child? So as an art piece, it's like, what if you actually activate the impossible dream? So I'm devoting the rest of my life to doing that. So that interests me. And it was always there. And I remembered in 2011...
Activate the impossible dream.
Yeah.
Now, what does that mean?
What did you want to be when you were a child?
A pool player.
How did that go for you?
Didn't work out. I didn't get the proper support from my family.
Okay, here's another question. When did you let that dream go, Tommy?
When I moved to Galway.
Do you ever think about it? Are you happy that you never became a pool player?
No, there are times now I have a pool table in the house. I have a pool table in the house and there are times now when the kids have gone to bed and I have a game against myself and I go, oh, I'd love to be doing this for a living.
Yeah. So mine never went away.
Yeah.
And I had this massive moment of clarity in my 40s and it was like, oh my God, I still really want to do this.
But why is it amazing to achieve it? And I know there are probably people who think that landing on the moon was the greatest thing we ever did. But why is it amazing to go to Mars?
Because we are this tiny ant living on a pretty insignificant planet.
Insignificant?
Yes, surrounded by a pretty insignificant star when you look at our place in the overall
space.
But
in whose head are we insignificant?
In terms of you look at yourself, if you say you're in space and you look at our size in relation to the whole of the observable universe,
yeah.
It's an incredible achievement that something that small is able to thrust itself
sure.
off a planet from which it was created and created for and then actually achieve, you know, defying forces of gravity, defying yeah. all the thrust and everything, and can actually land on Mars. That to me is a representation of the power of the collective will of humanity and being able to achieve that together. That's, to me, that's uplifting and it just shows you what we can do when we work together.
I remember a man said to me one time, it takes all types of people to make a world. And the fact that your deepest, strongest inclination is to get off the planet. I think following that is... So obviously it takes bravery to do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but it's also because of the planet that I want to do it. Do you know what I mean? It's to save the planet. It's to almost reflect back. And I don't know if you remember, and you're probably... You see, because space is so important to me, but there was a picture that was taken in 1968, the year before the moon landings. It's called Earthrise.
Mm, yeah.
And it was taken from the moon off the Earth. And it's half, the Earth is kind of lit, just a half of it is lit. And it began the whole environmental movement because for the first time ever, we were able to perceive ourselves from a distance. And I think bringing that change in perception is, to me, I would be absolutely privileged if I could help people see where they live differently and kind of cherish it and take better care of it.
I mean, that's one of the most beautiful photographs that
it is, yeah,
people
me, it
have
is.
Ever seen.
Yeah.
Our gorgeous blue...
Yeah.
planet in the midst of all this darkness. Yeah. How is it that journey going for you in terms of the effort to try and get to Mars? Like, where are you in your schedule?
It's immense. It's half of it was allowing myself want it. You know what I mean? To go from being in denial and then going, I'm actually going to do this. That was like a massive change. And then I just keep having conversations with people. People are amazing. Like, that's what I find is people are just amazing and they want to help. And the first door I knocked on was Blackrock Castle Observatory in Cork, and they've made me their artist in residence. And they introduced me to Science Foundation Ireland, who have funded me. And they've funded me twice now to make theatre shows about my dream to go to space, which is essentially about conversations and interactions that I've had with people. And out of that, I got to go to the Utah desert. Yeah. And then I was in Russia last year on a zero-gravity flight to understand what weightlessness is like. And one conversation begets another conversation, and now I feel like I'm building this team of people around me who support it and who want to help me get along the way. And even coming here tonight to talk to you helps me along the way. So it's a very long road that's ahead for me. It's physically very challenging. I am not your classic astronaut. I'm just Niamh Shaw from Dundalk, but I'm not giving up on it, and that's the most important part of it for me.
Yeah, I suppose there's the, you know, part of it, of a journey thing, is guessing how you might feel when you reach your destination.
Yeah.
And I suppose there's the possibility that we might be psychologically or spiritually damaged by not being on Earth. Have you thought about the dark side of being so homeless?
Yeah. I don't think we're supposed to live anywhere but Earth. But I think we can learn lessons by having some people leave Earth and share how difficult it is to come back and go, lads, we have it really good here. We shouldn't mess up this planet. You know, I got a taste of it when I was in the Utah desert. So every time you go outside, you have to wear a spacesuit. Now, you're only simulating it, you know, but like, you can't breathe on Mars. There is no oxygen. It's carbon dioxide. The temperatures are very, very low. There's storms all the time. So you have to live completely enclosed all the time. Their habitat has to be completely airtight and pressurized. There's radiation coming from space all the time. We have a beautiful atmosphere that protects us from so much radiation. So I got a feeling of that, and it's incredibly oppressive and claustrophobic to have very limited water, to live with freeze-dried food, to be in a tin can with the same four people, having the same conversations, and things break. The toilet broke for 3 days.
Sound like one of our
days.
Family holidays.
Yeah, mine too. you know, that there wasn't enough water. These are real things. Mm. So what it does is it makes me realise how lucky we are. And so I'm prepared to put myself through that.
How long would it take to get to Mars?
At the moment, with current technology, it takes 7 months. But Elon reckons it takes 8 weeks. That's what he's projecting.
He obviously knows a shortcut.
He does. He does. He goes the back roads. He goes the unapproved roads.
And are you surrounded by people in your life that support you? Family and stuff like that?
Yeah, yeah. They think I'm mental. Like, eventually, Mum and Dad are kind of... They've kind of finally gone, right, sure, you're going, so sure.
Yeah.
Can't stop you, I suppose. Yeah. But, yeah, they thought I was mental. Yeah, I don't know why.
But it could be a good mental.
It could be a good mental, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And are you close? Like, are you
no,
close
to achieving
it? No, it's
a very long way away. It's a very long way away. Mars won't happen, I would say, for about another 20 years.
Wow.
But I hope, like, if I can get to outside Earth's atmosphere, then I build up my reputation and I'll apply for the job of being just a minion. I don't have to be anyone special, just a minion who lays down the foundations for the next generation of people who want to come and visit it or live in it or whatever.
Dream big.
That's it, dream big. That's my motto.
Fair play to you. Ladies and gentlemen, so. Dr. Niamh Shaw.
That's a mighty ambition, Mrs. A mighty ambition, mighty.